Hey YouTube, Joyboy here. So, this video is primarily going to be focused on rocks and Blackbeard. But all the while, I think that we can touch on other subjects related to Blackbeard as well, because inevitably, if there is a connection here, it could relate to many other things. But before getting to the possible connection between Blackbeard and rocks, let's just start off by explaining rocks. Rox D. Zebek was essentially the pirate king before Gold D. Roger, 40 years before the current timeline in the story. Now, giving him this moniker, this title, may not entirely be the truth, but in terms of power, I think that 40 years before the beginning of the story, nobody rivaled Rox D. Zebek. Members of his crew included Big Mom, Kaido, Whitebeard, Shiki, Captain John. Rox was probably captain too and presided over the vast majority of pirates living during the time. So what exactly defines the Pirate King? Does Rox actually fulfill the criteria? These are questions that I'm not concerned with. They do not bother me. I don't think that they are particularly important to the point being made, which is if you have a pirate ruling over the vast majority of pirates, that is what I would call a Pirate King. And so with the power of the pirates behind him, Rox set out on a warpath, attacking and terrorizing the Marines and the world government. Based on the context in which Sengoku told us this story, I think that we can presume that Rox pushed the world government and the Marines to the very brink of destruction. This was a power and this was a force that could not be stopped. The Marines and government's basic duty of protecting the leaders of the world, the Celestial Dragons, was threatened. And with it, I think, the integrity of that entire establishment. Rox, for his part, though, has so far in the story been characterized in mainly two ways, that of violence, of cruelty, and by his interest in taboo subjects. Somehow, these two elements of his character were combined to lead him to the moment in which he arrived in God Valley, and the improbable occurred. Gold D. Roger and Monkey D. Garp combined forces and defeated Rox, all the while protecting the Celestial Dragons and slaves that were suggested to be located in God Valley. The circumstances surrounding all of this is very much unclear, but something that I think the story makes clear will become more apparent the more that we learn about it. But after Rox's defeat, his crew was disbanded and defeated, their own personal history covered up and erased from history, as well as the island of God Valley itself. Sengoku explains that during the time that they were active, Rox was the most famous pirate crew in the entire world, but today many people do not know of them because of the government's effort to cover everything up and the remaining Rox pirates' disinterest in discussing their times as part of Rox. So as of 38 years before the beginning of the story, the memory of Rox began to fade. And this memory is only being rekindled now because the alliance between Kaido and Big Mom as previous members of Rox, many in the government see this as a reformation of the Rox pirates. And so this leads us to Blackbeard, and we discussed this in my review for chapter 957, but we'll go ahead and talk about it again here now. Blackbeard has a connection with Rox, whether that be because he, just the same as Rox, has chosen the Pirate Island Beehive as his base of operations, just as the same place where Rox managed to recruit all of the top tier pirates from the pirate world several decades ago. But even more specifically, we learned in a Viva card recently that Blackbeard's ship is called the Sword or the Saber of Zebek. Rox's real name is Rox D. Zebek. I don't think that there is anything more definitive linking Blackbeard and Zebek and Rox than this. I think at the very least you have to ask some questions like, what is Oda thinking here? Why did he choose this name specifically, and does this hint at more? It paints a pretty strong argument that a Blackbeard at the very least might be influenced by him. But I think that a lot of people are not really thinking about this connection and what it means like they should be. Guys, we've already made this clear, the story has made this clear. Rox was, for the most part, erased from history. Yes, some people still know of them from the time in which they were active, but it's implied that the younger generations do not even know who Rox was. People have been blindsided by the reveal that three of the previous four Yonko were all members of the very same pirate crew. And to further complicate this, it is not like the former members of Rocks are boasting about their achievements and spreading their histories. It's stated specifically that they didn't like one another and they do not have a whole lot of interest in telling their own story. It seems that nobody, literally nobody in this world, is playing a pivotal role in inspiring younger pirates to be influenced by Rocks. On every front, whatever history there might have been that was not covered up, that was not altered in the news, it seems is being lost. And so that brings us to Blackbeard, who is 40 years old. The Rocks pirates were defeated 38 years before the current storyline. That means that by the time that Rocks was defeated, Blackbeard was 2 years old. He is not old enough to have been conscious when the Rocks pirates were famous. He is not old enough to remember the various deeds that the Rocks pirates achieved. He's really not old enough to be influenced by Rocks at all. I think that without direct and specific knowledge from some source that would have authority about information regarding Rocks, Blackbeard's interest in him cannot be explained. Now I want to make this very clear, guys. I'm not arguing that it is likely that Blackbeard has never heard of Rocks. I think that being on Whitebeard's ship, probably he became aware of a pirate crew that existed before the Whitebeard pirates, that Whitebeard himself was a member of a previous pirate crew, and that they were famous. These are things that I think are pretty reasonable to have existed on the pirate crew of a famous pirate who is a part of Rocks. But what I am saying is that it does not make a whole lot of sense for Blackbeard to know a lot of the specifics and have a lot of reasons to view Rocks as a kind of influential figure, somebody whose path that he should follow or in some way imitate. It just doesn't make a whole lot of sense for Blackbeard to be a protege, to be a disciple of Rocks, because he is not old enough. But I don't want to stop here. Let us press forward and talk about things that are far more crazy and far more interesting than this. It was pointed out to me by Dritz the Theorist that in the One Piece data book Green, made several years in the past, Oda gave us a hint about Blackbeard. Now, usually I do not trust these data books, but this particular one is hard to ignore. Previously in the One Piece story, Ace is having a conversation with Blackbeard where he tells Blackbeard that Blackbeard should be old enough to understand the consequences of his actions, in this case, the consequences of killing Thatch and betraying the Whitebeard crew. And Oda tells us in One Piece data book Green, and this seems very out of place, not what this story is suggesting at all, that Ace's comments regarding Blackbeard's age may be a hint to solving the mysteries of Blackbeard. This is not an implication that I think anybody got from the story itself. My usual criticism of the One Piece data books is that they extrapolate definitive information from what is being suggested from the story. For instance, the famous faux pas of one of the data books was that it said that Sabo was dead. And a lot of people in the community took that as fact because this was official material made by the people who make One Piece. If they say Sabo is in fact dead, he is dead. But this was not true, and we saw Sabo return in Dressrosa because the data book merely commented on or stated as fact something that was suggested to be fact from the story, but not necessarily a fact. These data books in large part do not exist to spoil the reveals that Oda has planned in the future. Obviously, Oda knew that Sabo was not dead, but if you have a little info piece on Sabo, of course, it's going to say that he's dead because the story suggests that it is so. However, this reveal about Blackbeard and his conversation with Ace is not what the story is suggesting whatsoever. This is a straight-up speculation within the One Piece data book, a green one that I find its inclusion to be very interesting. Why is Oda or his editors seemingly purposefully drawing our attention to Blackbeard's age and implying that his age may in some way be important to the various mysteries surrounding him? How could age even matter to begin with? Well, guys, Blackbeard is 40 years old, and the Rocks Pirates were defeated 38 years before the beginning of the story. As of right now, the existence and defeat of the Rocks Pirates is the only thing that in any way could coincide with Blackbeard's actual age. In this very conversation between Ace and Blackbeard, Ace is like, you should be old enough to understand the consequences of your actions killing a member of the Whitebeard Pirates. And what are the Rocks Pirates in part famous for? They are famous for their own members killing each other. The one ironclad rule of the Whitebeard ship was that you do not kill another crew member. And I have no doubt that this is in some way related to his time with Rocks. And here Blackbeard breaks this ironclad rule of the Whitebeard Pirates, and Ace says you are old enough to know better than that. And he's roughly the same age as the defeat of the Rocks Pirates, doing exactly the thing or one of the things that the Rocks Pirates were famous for. All of this is just very, very interesting to me. But let's go back to this concept of his age being important. Oda is pointing this out. This is a speculation from Oda and his editors themselves. I interpret this as a kind of clue. In what ways could Blackbeard's age be important? One of the more popular theories to arise after chapter 957 is Blackbeard, by the time that Rocks had died, was 2 years old. And that makes him just old enough to potentially be Rocks' son. I'm sure that there's going to be a lot of people that are going to look to Blackbeard's name, Marshall D. Teach, as critical evidence debunking the idea that he is Rocks D. Zbeck's son, because they do not share surnames, but at the same time, we have an example from the One Piece story in the case of Portgas D. Ace, in which he did not take the name of his father, and he did so for many varying reasons. So this could be true for Blackbeard, and it is because of this that we cannot outright debunk this idea. But at the same time, I'm going to stand here now and tell you guys that I'm not completely sold by the idea because I think that it just lacks a little bit of substance, right? We have this connection between Blackbeard and Rocks. Blackbeard might be following in his footsteps, might be influenced from him, is of an age in which it could make sense for him to be Rocks' son. It isn't outright debunked because of his age. And I think that people are just taking that one step too far. We need several other clues to really, I think, persuade me at the very least and persuade other people that this is, in fact, what is the case. So for me personally, I don't think that there's enough evidence to actually believe the idea. It's an idea that goes on the shelf as a maybe, while this would be cool, this is interesting, we'll see if we get more clues. I'm actually far more persuaded in what I think I would consider, and many other people would consider, a far crazier idea. Rocks D. Zbeck is not dead. And he and Marshall D. Teach share the very same body. This is, of course, a derivative of a very famous and popular theory within the community that I personally have stand for a very long time. And that is that Blackbeard is more than one person. We just discussed Blackbeard potentially being Rocks' son, and I told you guys that the big reason why I do not believe this is I just don't think that we have enough clues and evidence pointing our thoughts in that particular direction. It could be true, we just need to wait for more. But as far as Rocks and Blackbeard inhabiting the same body, I don't think that we really need any more clues other than what we already have to come to that conclusion and find a theory that we can believe. It's been noted on several occasions in the One Piece story that Blackbeard is just weird. There is something strange about him. In Marineford, after consuming a second devil fruit, which was supposed to be impossible for any regular human, Marco speculates that it may have something to do with his body. This was Marco's immediate gut reaction to Blackbeard obtaining more than one devil fruit. His first thought is, well, there was something strange about Blackbeard's body, perhaps it is this which has allowed him to consume more than one fruit. And at the risk of sounding a little bit risque here, I think that Marco, having been on the same crew as Blackbeard for 20 years, is somewhat of a source of expertise when it comes to Blackbeard's strangeness in his body. But really, please, here, no fan art. And I think that this aligns well with other oddities from the One Piece story. In chapter 225 in the Jaya arc, shortly after Luffy and Blackbeard first met, Nami asks Luffy, who is he? And Luffy and Zoro respond, don't know. But it's not he, it's they. Guys, there are many translations of this scene. Many translations. They all translate it ever so slightly differently, but it all conveys the very same meaning. Blackbeard is more than one person. And so immediately after saying this, Nami questions Zoro and Luffy as to what exactly they mean. Because saying that somebody is more than one person isn't something that you hear every day, and you must assume that they mean something else. So she asks them, are you referring to his crew or somebody else? To which we do not get a response. The popular counter-argument to this interpretation of this panel is that what Luffy and Zoro were referring to is not Blackbeard himself, but his crew the entire time. I'm letting you guys know that you're going to see that when you scroll in the comments. It might be really highly upvoted, but I personally disagree with this interpretation completely. And at the very least, you must acknowledge that Oda is selling the idea that Blackbeard himself could be more than one person, because Nami herself asked that question. What do you mean he's not a he, he's a they? Oda here is drawing attention to the ridiculousness of Zoro and Luffy's response to her question, which specifically asked who Blackbeard was. She didn't ask anything about this person's companion. She wanted to know about him. And Luffy and Zoro's response is incredibly vague, seemingly impossible, and not elaborated on. Anyway, guys, I'm going to argue probably until I die or until it is revealed in the story that this is an important panel and sequence in One Piece and holds mysteries that have yet to fully unveil themselves. But I would say that the common speculation regarding this interpretation is that Luffy and Zoro essentially noticed the same thing that Marco noticed. The reason why Marco's first reaction to Blackbeard obtaining two devil fruits is say, well, there's something weird about his body. Luffy and Zoro sometime during this scene have noticed this very same thing and come to the conclusion that Blackbeard may not be one person. And so this is where we want to get into Blackbeard's Jolly Roger. And so guys, the vast majority of the time, the Jolly Roger of a pirate crew in some way reflects or gives hints on or has some sort of homage to the captain of that crew. Big Mom's Jolly Roger has candy and has her trademark lipstick. Whitebeard's had his mustache. Kaido's has his horns. Shanks has his scars. You can go on the One Piece Wiki and look at all of the various pirate crew Jolly Rogers that exist, and 99% of them all reflect their captain, or the identity and theme of the crew itself. And so if you take the time to look at Blackbeard's Jolly Roger, you must ask how that relates to Blackbeard himself or his crew. And the Jolly Roger depicts three skulls. What does three skulls have to do with the Blackbeard pirates or Blackbeard? Perhaps it insinuates that Blackbeard is three people. So in all, I believe there to be four bits of evidence suggesting that Blackbeard is more than one person. How is Blackbeard able to consume more than one devil fruits when it is seemingly impossible? Only one devil fruit per user? Well, if he was more than one person, then he could consume more than one devil fruit. Marco comments about the strangeness of his body. Luffy and Zoro remark upon how Blackbeard may be more than one person. He is not a he is a them. And Blackbeard's Jolly Roger might shed clues onto that nature. And this is without including what I consider to be half evidence, which is Blackbeard's own strange personality, how he can sort of switch between different almost personality types. One second he can be silly and jovial and then go straight into commanding and in control, then to cowardly. Blackbeard really is all over the place, and many people get the impression that he could suffer from some kind of multiple personality disorder. But I think that from this point onward, the speculation really just sells itself. You merely need to combine this theory of Blackbeard being more than one person with the idea that he is in some way influenced by rocks, when it really doesn't make a whole lot of sense for that to be the case. Maybe Blackbeard is influenced by the rocks pirates in Rock D. Zebek, because Rocks's soul, or Rocks, is in some way part of Blackbeard. And this leads us back to the data book and Oda or Oda's editor's hint that Blackbeard's age might be important. Is this clue leading to the reveal that at least a part of Blackbeard has already experienced a full life? And was it through this life experience that led Blackbeard to wait to find the Yami Yami no Mi before he tried to take control of this world? I think that we all have to agree that the way that Blackbeard has decided to go about gaining power is incredibly weird, right? He was on Whitebeard's crew for 20 years, looking specifically for this devil fruit, and otherwise not drawing attention to himself, or at least not drawing too much attention to himself, for the potential and the power that he really had. And to me, it almost by itself argues for the fact that Blackbeard has already experienced life and defeat. It's careful to an absurd degree. If Blackbeard had never found the Yami Yami no Mi, we are led to believe that he would have died in ambiguity. It was this devil fruit or no devil fruit. And that's just not how young minds think. I think that only time and experience leads someone to the final form of a plan. For most everybody else, it is a step-by-step process. You take each day as they come and work from there. But Blackbeard started from the very beginning with the end game in mind. But I think that the obvious question that should be asked from all of this is, how is this even possible? How is it possible for two people to live within the same body? How did we get to this point? And I'm not sure that I have a great answer for you. Maybe there exists a devil fruit or a power or a kind of technology which allows for this. Maybe a loyal member of the Rock's pirates wanted Rock's Dzebek to live on. So in order to prolong his life or in a way resurrect him, they gave him a new body. Or perhaps this is the result of scientific experimentation from the Marines and agents of the government. Going back to Punk Hazard, we can see a chamber in which there are many criminals frozen in ice. I personally would speculate and I personally assume that these are our test subjects. What exactly happened to Rox after the battle in God Valley? We presume it's reported that he died, but is that what really happened? Can you trust the news? No. Was he in fact, rather than killed, was he captured? And was he perhaps, like these other people, test subjects to be used, their bodies used for the purposes of science? And did the science lead his soul to inhabit the body of some young kid? The real Marshall D. Teach. Why would they do this kind of experimentation, you might ask? Well, why is it that Blackbeard is able to consume more than one devil fruit? Is this perhaps the aim of that science? To make some kind of supermarine with multiple devil fruits? Another thing that I want to point out to you guys that I personally find to be interesting, we've already talked about Blackbeard's own Jolly Roger and how the Jolly Roger usually reflects the captain and in almost all cases reflects either the captain or the nature and theme of the crew. Well, we've seen the Rock's Pirates Jolly Roger and there are some unique aspects of it that as of yet are not explained but could give us clues onto the nature of Rock's himself. My first impression upon seeing this Jolly Roger is that it appears to indicate Rox had some kind of devil fruit ability. My first impression upon reading the chapter was that maybe Rox had Ace's Mara Mara no Mi. But another idea suggested to me on Twitter, I find to be a little bit more interesting and is more relevant to what we are discussing now, is that maybe Rox was the original owner of the Yami Yami no Mi. The resemblance is surely there. We have a swirl which indicates the devil fruit ability, in my opinion, and what appears to be a kind of flame. But if you look at when Blackbeard uses the Yami Yami no Mi, there's tendrils of darkness that appear a lot like flames and could very well be depicted here in Rox's Jolly Roger. And lastly, guys, I just want to point out that if this theory is true, it would explain a lot about the motivations and potential plans that Blackbeard may have in the future, right? Blackbeard right now is sort of ambiguous, right? We know that he wants something, but you know, what is Blackbeard's real end game? In chapter 957, Sengoku paints us a picture of Rox as somebody who was actively looking to become king of the world, not king of the pirates, king of the very world itself, and who is directly fought against the Marines and the government in order to displace the Celestial Dragons and maybe even Aimsama. Either way, guys, I think that we have enough here to be curious, at the very least. And enough here, in my estimation, to believe in something pretty wacky. But yeah, guys, that is the idea that I wanted to share with you today. As always, I'm curious as to what you guys think. Share your thoughts in the comment section below. Like the video if you like the video, dislike the video if you dislike the video. Make sure to subscribe if you want to be notified for my future content. And as always, guys, have a wonderful day.